Welcome back, everybody. Some people may have an unpleasant coworker in their office, but others may actually be dealing with a bully. The people at Workplace Bullying Institute in Bellingham want to help. They have a number of programs and several books, including this one, The Bully at Work, aimed at helping individuals and employers defuse bullying situations and create better workplaces. Here to tell us more are Institute co-founders Drs. Ruth and Gary Namie. Welcome.
Thank you.
Glad you're doing this. I mean, this is really something we don't think about. We've been talking a lot about bullying in schools, of course, but this continues well into adulthood for some people, and you had your own story.
Oh, yeah. I was working in a big hospital, and I transferred to a small clinic, and I met the boss from hell. She treated me wonderful for 2 weeks, and then it started behind closed doors. It was, you did this wrong, you did that wrong, you look wrong, you talk wrong. Then it went out, and within 9 months, there she was telling me, well, you can be a secretary now because I've canceled all your clients. And I had a doctorate in psychology, and I thought, whoa. And 7 months later, after she told me that, I was handed a check by their lawyer, and I said, what did I do wrong? And he said to me, you did nothing wrong. He said, she's the one that gets everybody in trouble. And I said, how come she's still working and I'm not? And he said, because she'd make more trouble than you make.
Interesting. And I think, I think that's how people get away with this in part, right?
Right.
Gary, how would you describe a workplace bullying situation? We heard one story, but what are the other ways that it might manifest?
It can be subtle. It can be overt. It could be behind closed doors. It could be the screaming Mimi out in front of everybody else going for a public display. Screaming and yelling and cursing is a prototype, Bobby Knight. But the truth is, behind closed doors, somebody's going to rip into your sense of identity and actually try and steal it. They're going to try and convince you you're incompetent, when in fact, the reason they targeted you is because you're the smartest cookie on the street. You're the veteran worker. You're the go-to expert, and they can't stand it. Now, that can be a boss. Typical scenario would be when it's, most of the time, it's boss to worker, subordinate. So if it's a boss, they just want to take you out. If it's a co-worker, they use all kinds of tricks to basically ostracize you because social isolation to a human being is so devastating.
It's almost the worst thing that can happen to us. That's why
it's a form of torture.
It is indeed,
yes.
According to the Geneva Convention. So we know that that's true. Listen, when do we draw the line between bullying and illegal harassment, when people can actually take legal action? Where does that cross over?
Illegal harassment is bullying, very narrowly defined, where both you and Ruth are members of protected status groups according to American law. But if you start ripping into Ruth as a coworker, the law goes out. You see, Ruth's bully was named Sheila, and last we checked, she was still a woman. I know she's still working there, but the point is, when it's woman on woman or same race, the law is invisible. In other words, it's just inapplicable. You would go to HR and they would say, I'm sorry, there's nothing we can do because it's not illegal. If you have to be a protected person, but if you're both protected, it's nullified. Bullying is four times more prevalent. It's the whole pie of mistreatment. And illegal, if you imagine a narrow slice, is the illegal part.
It's just a part of it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you guys did a survey on workplace bullying in 2010, and here were some of the key findings. 35% of the people you surveyed had experienced workplace bullying firsthand at work, and I'm sure many more have seen it in others. 62% of the bullies were men, 58% of the targets were women, and as you mentioned, bullying four times more prevalent than illegal harassment. So what can people do? What's the proper step to take if you feel you're being targeted in this way?
Well, you need to take care of yourself first, and you need to check your health, check what's going on. The thing you don't do is you don't do comeback lines. You don't go and you don't confront the bully. That'll bite you back and make you worse than you were.
In response to Ruth's experience, we have been doing this 15 years. We've heard every variation of story imaginable. And so what we know is the target cannot defend him or herself at that moment. And because it's so health harming, as she said, health is the key, it causes PTSD. Why would you get a war wound when it's a workplace. That, mm-hmm. Therefore, it's a war mm-hmm. zone. So for a lot of folks with clinical depression, overwhelming, debilitating anxiety, it's an emotional case to make. So when you want to get even, you're going to be emotional. So what we coach people to do in the bully at work and at the website and when they call for advice is you have to take the emotion out. It's the hardest thing, Margaret.
Very difficult.
You've got to make a business case the bully's too expensive to keep. So in essence, that's what you got to do.
That's a smart strategy.
But your coworkers will not back you, and you've got to know it.
No.
And it's just get over it. Don't get hurt. That's just the nature of the beast. And really, it's up to the employers.
Yeah.
Well, it's great that you're doing this work. I think employers need to be more proactive, obviously, in protecting people who aren't doing anything wrong instead of people who are. And you're working on a healthy workplace bill, I understand. Is that correct?
In the absence of a law, we have been working since a few years into the movement, since the early 2000s. 21 states have introduced our bill, but we're here to report here in 2012. We don't yet have a law in any state.
And we
we're
should.
Not, we should. Yeah. It's the last form of traumatizing harassment and mistreatment and abuse, you see. We define it in the law as abuse, too. And yet it's the last taboo.
Well, you guys have two books and a website. We're going to point people towards those. But thank you for doing this work. I mean, I think it's a sign of character to protect those who need to be protected and to stand by people who need to be protected.
Yes.
And you're a wonderful example.
Well,
I'm sorry that you.
You
went through that.
Well, it's brought us where we are today, and hopefully it's brought us to help lots and lots of people. And that's what we do now, and that's what hopefully is our life's work, and it makes us happy.
Well,
good.
Thank you.
We want more people to know about it, so you can find more information online about the work being done at the Workplace Bullying Institute. Please check it out, because if you're not needing this right now, you might later. Just go to king5.com/newday, and we'll link you over. We'll be back after this. Thank you both very much.